Hello everyone, today we are going to go through a linear regression example in R. Before we start, let's discuss what a linear regression is. Linear regression involves continuous x, predictor, and y, response, variables. Examples of continuous variables include time, age, height, and weight. Let's look at a regular plot with the x and y axes labeled. Remember, both are continuous variables. We can put a bunch of points on this plot and think of these points as our raw data, or observations. We can fit a line to these points that best represents their trend. This is our regression line. This line follows the formula y equals mx plus b. Let's remind ourselves of what each of these elements means. This formula finds y, the response variable. To do so, it uses the product of the slope of the line and the x value at a given point. Then, the formula adds b, the y-intercept, which is the point where the regression line intersects with the y-axis. Let's choose a random point on our plot. We want to know what the y, or response, value is for this point. For the same point, we need to know the x value, the slope, which is the rise over run of the line, and the y-intercept. This equation is useful for understanding how the predictor variable is affecting the response and can be used to predict values outside of our data range. Another thing to consider is how well this regression line actually fits our data. For this, we use R-squared. This tells us the amount of variance in the response variable that is explained by the predictor. So the higher the R-squared, the better fit the regression line is to the raw data. Now we are ready to move on to an example in R. As usual, we need to read in the necessary libraries, which in this case are ggplot2 and ggpubr. We then need to set our working directory. Now I'm going to read in my file called student grades. Let's take a look at the data. Note that we use headers equals true when reading in our data frame, as I want R to recognize that my first row includes all the names of each of my columns. Our data tells us student ID, the number of hours each student spends studying for an upcoming exam, their grade on that exam, and their current grade in the overall course. I want to know, does the number of hours a student spends studying influence their exam grade? Note that number of hours and exam grade are two continuous variables. To assess if there's a significant relationship between these two variables, we can create a linear regression model, or LM. This function follows the formula of LM, the response variable, followed by the predictor variable, then data set to the name of your data frame. Let's plug in our information. Our y variable is the exam grade, and our x variable is the hour spent studying, and our data frame name is df. I'm going to name this model and run it. The summary information of the model is going to tell us a lot of interesting things. We can see that hour studying does have a statistically significant effect on the student's exam grade, as the p-value is less than 0.05. This also tells us things like the r-squared and adjusted r-squared and the f-statistic. Now that we know that our trend is statistically significant, we are going to want to plot this. We want to create a ggplot with the aesthetics of x set to hours studying and y set to exam grade. We then want to include geom point to plot our raw data. To create a regression line, we can use geom smooth and set method to LM for linear model. Note that this uses the formula to create the line and also creates standard error shading around the line. I'm also going to create custom axis titles for my x and y axes because I don't want the labels to include the underscores. Scale x and scale y continuous allows me to customize the axis labels, boundaries, and breaks. Now all of this theme stuff just cleans up the background and outline of the ggplot. The code written here makes the background solid white with no grid lines and creates a black rectangle around the entirety of the plot. Stat regline equation allows us to customize the plot with the r squared and the equation of the regression line directly on the plot. Label y sets where this text is positioned on the plot. Note that this is out of the scale of your y values. So my maximum y value is 100, 100% on an exam. So this puts the text at the top of my plot. If your maximum value is, let's say, 5, and you set this to 100 as I have here, it would be far off from the plot and it will skew the rest of your data and regression line. If you have any problems with this, first ensure that the position actually fits the range of your plot. Now we can finally render the plot. We can see that with increasing hours spent studying, the exam scores generally also increases, so there is a positive relationship between the predictor and response variables. Towards the top, we have the equation and the r-squared. Our r-squared is pretty high here, meaning that the regression line is a pretty good fit to our data. Our equation also tells us the y-intercept and the slope of the line itself. If we remember back to the model summary, this trend is statistically significant. So we can answer our original question and say that there is a significant positive effect of hours spent studying on exam scores. Check out my page if you're interested in more video tutorials in R or QGIS. If you have any other questions or suggestions, please put them in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video and found this helpful. Thank you for watching.